episode of Those Books. Welcome back to my channel, and also this is the first day of the Because We Can readathon. This round, our hosts are doing a Disney theme. The Daily Creative Challenge has been designed around a different Disney character for each day. I will leave all the information in the description box below if you want to check out what this readathon is all about, and if you want to keep up all the other creative challenge videos. Okay, so I will introduce what today's challenge is and my contribution, but I wanted to first start with the TBR. So in addition to those creative challenges each day, there's also reading challenges. You can double up on these challenges. You can squeeze as many into one book as you want. I managed to get all of the prompts in 3 to 4 books. At first it was 3 books, then I was like, oh no, I have to read this other book, and so I added it, but now I'm kind of not liking another book, so now I'm kind of more or less back down to 3 books for all of these challenges. Anyways, I'm gonna go ahead and tell you what books I picked out, then we'll go through the challenges, and I'll tell you which books fit those challenges. The first book is the group book, which is Reflection by Elizabeth Lim. This is a Mulan Twisted Tales retelling. If you are not familiar with it, Twisted Tales, I believe, are maybe middle grade or YA. No, they're probably more YA, come to think of it. They're like young adult series that retell all different types of, like the Disney movie, they take that rendition and retell that story. I've read only one. Also, each book is written by a different author, so I think that's really cool if you have a specific author but you don't necessarily want to read all of them. That's really cool. Anyways, so this one's a Mulan retelling, and I ended up getting this one on audiobook. The second book I chose is Well of Ascension by Brandon Sanderson. This is the second book in the Mistborn trilogy. This is a high fantasy, it has a big magic system, all this political stuff, and it's a phenomenal concept. However, I do have to say that, like, as I'm kind of getting into this one, it's been a bit of a slow start. I'm running into some really slow parts that really are kind of starting to drag. But then within that, I can't like not read it, or I can't like skip it, because there's some really important information on topics that I'm really fascinated about mixed in. So I just have to be patient, because it will be worth it in the end. But yeah, I've been working on this book since last month. I'm about halfway through. We'll see if I can finish this during the week. I'm really, really gonna try hard. And thankfully the other books that I've kind of chose for this are really easy reads. So I think it's possible. I think that's all I have to say about this. I can't really give a synopsis of this without spoiling something in the first book. And if you haven't read that, like, you can't. So it's really good. If you haven't read it, go read it. The next book I picked I have it on ebook, Kingdom of Flesh and Fire by Jennifer L. Armentrout. I'm doing really good here, by the way. I have an audiobook, a physical book, and an ebook, and I really like to see that when I'm choosing books for like a readathon. For at least 2 of these, I already have a good chunk started. This is the second book in the From Blood and Ash series by Jennifer L. Armentrout, and this is basically an adult romance vampire series. I read the first one last month. It was so, so good. However, the second one, this is the one I might end up DNFing, at least DNFing for now, just because I am not really enjoying it. I'm very bored. The fourth book, I had to add this one because I have to read this by the 17th, and that is Spiritbound, which is the 5th in the Vampire Academy series. We are doing our live show on the 17th. 17th? I'm pretty sure on the 17th. So if you don't know, I'm co-hosting the Vampire Academy and Bloodlines series read along with some friends. Again, since it's so far in the series, I can't really sum it up. It's another vampire series. To be honest, actually, the one thing I can say is that between From Blood and Ash series and the Vampire Academy series, they kind of are similar in the way that they have different types of vampires. Just saying. So let's go ahead and get into the reading challenges. The first challenge is to read a retelling of any Disney Animated Studios film and then watch the film. So the book that will fit for this one is the group book Reflections, because I can read the book and watch Mulan. I can't decide if I want to rewatch the newest real life picture one or the cartoon one. Or maybe I'll just watch them both. The second challenge is to read a book that features royalty. Actually, I think all of the books could fit this. We have, well, all the royal families in this series. We have some kings in this series. From Blood and Ash, we have a prince, and obviously their royals. We got that one covered. The next challenge is to read a book based on mythology. This one, I was kind of on a stretch because I have two vampire books on here, and I would say that it's not exactly mythology, but vampire lore could fit, I think. That's what we're gonna go with. The only other thing I think is possibly Mulan, but again, it's not mythology. It's, I actually looked it up. So it's based on Hua Mulan, who was a Chinese warrior woman who lived during the Northern and Southern dynasties. Her history was told through the Ballad of Mulan. Now it's possible that she was a real person, but it's largely believed that her story is fictional. And then Well of Ascension does not have any mythology that I could see. So challenge number three is to read a book that focuses on family. Well, definitely the Mulan story. She's very like devoted to her family. And that's the whole reason she went into the army to begin with, was to like save her dad. So that definitely works. This has like found family, which is pretty cool. That could definitely work. Sort of, kind of, if you want to say vampire family, because they kind of all consider themselves cousins if they're all the Morois. And at least in the last book in the series, we got to meet a favorite character's, all of their close family unit. So that could work. The next challenge is to read a book with the Chosen One trope. For this challenge, I would have to read Kingdom of Flesh and Fire. I think that's the only book that uses that Chosen One trope. It's likely the closest match for the Chosen One trope because we have Poppy, who is the maiden, and she's basically been chosen. However, if I don't end up reading that, I'm not really sure what other ones could work. I think in Well of Ascension it could potentially work, just because our main character is very powerful. And also there's another couple of background characters that really play into the origin story, who I believe there's kind of like a Chosen One trope in there somewhere. I know it's a little bit of a stretch, but if I don't read the other one, we're going for it, okay? Challenge number six is to read a book that features a familiar. And I can't tell you what it is, but if you've read this book, you know. Oh, wait, Mulan could work, actually. But there's that one, Osur, or I cannot say that name. My lips just do not want to work that way. Or actually, Mulan would work because she's got like Mushu, the little dragon, and the little cricket, at least from the Disney version. I don't know if it's gonna work in the actual book, but it's supposed to be based off of the Disney movies. And the last challenge is to read a book that features a strong villain. Again, basically all three books will work in this. We have Gary shit in this book, and then we have Strigoi's, and then Mulan. Who knows what our like antagonist in the actual book is, because it is like a twisted tale. So I'm very excited to figure out like who our antagonist is for that one. Cannot figure out who the real antagonist is in JLA book. It just seems like everybody sucks. So that's the TBR. Those are the books that I plan on reading. So let's go ahead and get into today's challenge. The challenge for today is based off of Mulan. Let's get down to business. Mulan trains hard to be the best warrior she can be. Show us a training montage for the activity of your choosing. This actually came at a pretty good time. 2021, I really started out the year great with working out pretty regularly. But I have since kind of fallen off the bandwagon, and I don't want to go too long. I want to get back into it. So I thought this was a really fun way to get started again. We are going to work out like Mulan. I did actually a lot of research on this. First, we went back to the original training montage where she's like carrying buckets. I could do that. But all the other stuff I can't really do because I don't have like bombs and stuff or a bow and arrow. If I had a bow and arrow, I would totally go practice, but I do not have a bow and arrow. I even considered going and purchasing one for this, but yeah, that was a little much. Also, I looked up a lot of really cool videos. I'm gonna just leave all these links for you below too, just because I found them really interesting and it really just kind of fit the mood for today. A lot of really good videos on what it was like for the actors to train for the real life movie. And our main character, what is her name? Her name is Yifei Liu. I believe that's how you say it. I watched an interview with her where she said that it helped her a lot to be familiar with martial art for this movie production. She also said that she, 6 to 8 hours a day, some of the action scenes, and like, dang, they showed like her like doing these like lunging motions. I cannot imagine lunging for 6 hours a day. Like, could you? No wonder she's in such good shape. I did find a really fun video that anybody can do if you want to do it by YouTuber Kyra Pro. She does all different types of really unique workout videos. The one I ended up doing was part 5 in the Mulan dance workout series that she made, which is also linked below. But I really liked this video because you could listen to really nice compilations of songs from the movie, and then her dance moves really kind of go along with the mood and the Mulan theme, and I thought it was just really well done, and it was a lot of fun to do. I could not help feeling like Mulan while I was doing this workout today. So I will just show you the montage right now.
Hi friends, so today we are doing a Mulan inspired dance workout because Mulan is coming out this week and I am so pumped. Let's get into it.
In a thundering herd, we feel a lot like cattle.
Like a pounding beast, our aching feet are easy to ignore.
Hey! Think of instead a girl worth fighting for. Huh? That's what I said, a girl worth fighting for.
I couldn't care less what she'll wear or what she looks like. It all depends on what she cooks like. Beef, pork, chicken.
And the local girls thought you were quite the charmer.
And I'll bet the ladies love a man in armor.
Guess what
me,
I miss the most, since even
what do we want?
A girl worth fighting for.
My girl will think I have no faults,
that I'm a major find.
How about a girl who's got a brain, who always speaks her mind?
My manly ways and turn of phrase are sure to thrill her.
He thinks he's such a lady killer.
I'm a girl back home, unlike any other.
Yeah, the only girl who'd love him is his mother.
What do we want? Wish that I had.
This is what you give me to work with. Well, honey, I've seen worse. We're gonna turn this sow's ear into a silk purse. We'll have you washed and dried, trimmed and polished till you glow with pride. Just my recipe for instant bride. You'll bring honor to us all. Wait and see when we're through. Boys will gladly go to war for you. With good fortune and a great hairdo, you'll bring honor to us all.
Our girl can bring her family great honor in one way, by striking love for match, as this could be the day.
Men want girls with good taste, obedient, who work fast-paced, with good breed it,
and a tiny waist.
You'll bring honor to us all.
We all must serve our emperor, who hides us from the world. Come back, my very heart, but you, my very son.
When we're through, when we're fear, let your face blossoms like the veil.
You're better. Not yet. An apple for serenity, a pendant for balance, beads of jade for beauty. You must proudly show it. Now add a cricket just for luck, and even you can't blow it.
Ancestors, hear my plea. Help me not to make a fool of me, and to not uproot my family tree. Keep my father standing tall.
Dear family undertaker, we are meeting our matchmaker.
Just to be.
Alright guys, so I hope that you guys enjoyed that my challenge entry for today. That's why I'm all sweaty. It's actually a really good workout. I could struggle there for a little bit, as you could tell with some of the dance moves. I literally did not watch it until I turned it on and started doing the workout. It probably would have helped to maybe at least try it first before filming it, but this is what we're doing. This is definitely a really good like beginner getting into working out video. I did work up a really nice sweat, and my shoulders, I was actually really surprised how much my shoulders like were feeling it, and it was a good workout. So let me know if you went ahead and did it, because it was actually really fun. Still, I still have no idea what I'm doing for this week. Either, what am I gonna start reading? I'm going to start reading Reflections first, just because I have quite a lot of house cleanup to do, and I need to do some prep cooking for like the weekend and the week. I think it'd be a really good time to get through an audiobook. I actually have a whole bunch of other audiobooks as well, but I will read that one first.
Order! People, order!
Retrieve the arrow.
I'll get that arrow, pretty boy, and I'll do it with my shape on.
Fulfill your duties calmly and respectfully. Reflect before you snack.
Act. To please your future in-laws, you must demonstrate a sense of dignity and refinement.
Back one moment.
Ah!